Hello everyone, my name is Jackie Duong. I'm a program manager on Microsoft Planner, and I'll be talking about how to automate your Planner tasks workflow today. Every team is different, and every team works differently. Everyone has different task management workflows. We want to empower you to work flexibly and efficiently to feel in control of the tasks by enabling you to automate and customize your workflows.
Let's take an example from Elvis' team. They drive social media across Contoso Transit and manage a planner board to track all of the upcoming social media posts and messages that they need to relay to customers. They use this board to create new tasks to track future social media posts, as well as to take requests from other teams on what they need posted. This team tracks these requests through Microsoft Form. Let's say an engineering team needs a social media post for an upcoming new feature that they have built. They can request that here. They want this posted next week. When the team submits the form here, a task gets automatically created in the needs triage bucket with all of the details from the form. Additionally, there's a social media partnerships teams channel that the Elvis team tracks. In this team's channel, we can see that there was a new social request added, and all of those details from the form is posted here so that the whole team knows about this new request to look out for. Next, whenever somebody completes a post and then completes the task, it's important to follow up on the data from that social media post to make sure it was successful and so that we can look at the data insights and learn from the post. We can see here that a follow-up task got created to get insights from that post, assigning it to Vicky on the team. And this is due a week from now. All of this is possible through a quick and easy flow that I'll walk you through in this session. Elvis' team can save time with these redundant tasks by building flows. Let's take a few steps back to learn about Power Automate, Planner, how they work together, and then I'll walk you through how to build these flows.
Power Automate is a tool that allows you to create automated workflows to connect a variety of apps and services, both in and outside of Microsoft, without any code. Power Automate allows you to be more productive by minimizing repetitive and manual tasks to create more time to take care of more important tasks. So hopefully everyone here knows what Planner is. It's an intuitive task management tool that allows you to add and sort your team's tasks in a Kanban board. Planner allows your team to work together and feel in control of getting things done. You can combine Power Automate and Planner to automate repetitive tasks and create intelligent workflows. Power Automate involves zero code, so you can develop your own workflows or leverage existing templates that others have created. In the template gallery, there are over 96 pre-made templates involving Planner that you can immediately benefit from today. With Power Automate, you can flow data from one app into Planner or out of Planner. Microsoft 365 allows you to transform the way you work. The Productivity Cloud brings together the best-in-class apps and services to help you and your team achieve more. You can use Power Automate to move data from one M365 tool into Planner to create a seamless workflow based on how you work. Let's go back to the original scenario where Elva, the social media manager, takes requests for what to post on their company's social media through a Microsoft form. She uses this form to create tasks to remember to create these posts at the right time. Instead of doing this manually, let's create a flow for her.
Here is the social media intake form. And here is the planner plan that Elva and her team uses to manage all of the social media that needs to get posted for Contoso Transit. To get started with creating a flow to bring the form responses directly into the Microsoft Planner plan, we need to go to the Power Automate app. You can access Power Automate by going to flow.microsoft.com or in the app launcher, looking for the Power Automate app. Once we're in Power Automate, we can quickly get started. I did mention templates before. You can actually just go directly to the templates button in the left nav to see all of the templates that Power Automate has to offer, some which include Planner and many others involved as well. But today we're going to create a flow. So I'm going to click on Create. There are many ways to start from a blank flow. In this case, we're going to choose an automated flow because we want to create a flow when something happens, when a certain event happens. In our case, it will be when a form gets submitted. So I can actually just look for Microsoft Forms and see there's already an event and trigger that I can use when a new response is submitted. I'm going to create my flow. So we care about new responses being submitted in our Contoso Transit social media requests form. So now whenever there's a new response submitted there, this flow will kick off. We also want to get all the data from that response. So I'm going to actually just click on Forms again and click on Get Response Details. This will help us get all of the information associated with that response that was just submitted. We already have the ID of their form from the previous step, so I can actually just click on Response ID here, and this will get all of the details that were submitted that started this flow. Now that we have all of this information, we want to actually create the task in Planner. I can click on New Action and search for Planner. You can see there's a lot of actions here, but what we want to do is create a task. To choose the right plan, we need to choose the correct group. Once I choose my group, I can choose my plan name, and I can name this task whatever I want. I'm going to make it a social media request. And since there may be many social media requests, I want to be able to differentiate each one. I can add the response ID into the title so that each of my tasks can be differentiated based on which response they are. I can also choose which bucket I want to add them to. I want to add all of these tasks into my needs triage bucket so that we know we need to look into these tasks before we assign them out. I'll add the start date as when the form was submitted, and we can make the due date the date that was requested in the initial form intake. So we can go back to our get response details and see all of the information that we had from the form. We had the question, when would you like this posted? And we can make that response the due date. I can assign this task to anyone I want, but I'm actually going to assign it to myself as Elva here, since Elva will be the one who needs to reassign this out and make sure that she can assign it to the right person on her team. Now that we've created the task, we want to actually make sure that the information from the initial request is added into the task. I'm going to click on New Action, and I'm going to just click on Update Task Details. I want to update the task details of the task that we just created. So we can go to that step and select ID. We want to fill out the description to have all of the information so that Elva's team knows what actions to take. So I'm just going to put who requested this in case we need to follow up on the person who requested the social media, and get that email address from the original get response details. And then I'll add in all of the content from the question of what needs to be posted into what channel. So now we have the description filled out on this task. Our next step in that flow is to notify our entire team that there was a response that there was a new social media request. So I'm going to click on New Step once again. And since our team uses Teams, we can actually just make a post into Microsoft Teams. I want to specifically post as the Flowbot to the entire channel. So I have this action here, post a message as the Flowbot to a channel. I can choose which team I want the post to go in, and I can go into my Teams team and choose the right channel. We don't really want to spam the general channel that we do all of our conversations in, but we can put it in our social media partnerships just so that notification is out there. So now I want to make sure that the message makes sense to everybody. So I will put a little message saying new social media request by
and make sure that we get the right information in there. Additionally, we want to make sure that people know what was requested. So we can add the title of the plan or the task, as well as the original content that was in the form submission. We can save that. Now we can test this. Let's go back to our form and make a submission. I'm just going to say test my new flow so we'll know if it works, and just choose a random date in the future. So I submitted this, and let's see if it shows up in our plan. So I just saw a new task come in, social media request 14. And I can see the content says test my new flow. So that's the task that we, or the flow that we just created. So that's the form that we just submitted. We can also go to Teams and see if that was added as well. And there it is. So we now know that the new flow that we just created together is working. This lets Elva flow data from Microsoft Forms into Planner and into Teams simply and quickly. And it makes her life a lot easier. With Power Automate, you can create real-time task change workflows. Your plan and team is specific to how you and your team work. You can use Power Automate to help maximize the efficiency of managing and completing all of your tasks within a plan. Let's go back to Elva. Every time someone completes a social media post, she wants the Data Insights team member to follow up a week later to measure the success of the social media post. Instead of manually creating tasks and assigning them out and setting due dates every time there's a completed social media post and task, she can just create a flow. So let's switch over to flow. Once again, we'll hit the Create button to create our flow. Since we're going to be looking for when tasks get completed in this plan, we'll be creating an automated flow again. We'll look for planner triggers, and we'll see that there's a when a task is completed trigger. And that's how we'll create our task. We can select the group that we want to look for the plan in, and then the plan name. Next, we want to create a new task. I can search for planner and create a task. Once again, I'll have to choose the group before I choose the plan that I'm looking for. And then I'll give it a title. I'm going to make the title Get Insights From, and then add the title of the completed task. So I can see from that previous trigger, there are some data that was returned. So I can get the title from the task that was completed. We want to follow up on this in the follow-ups bucket. So that's where I'll select the bucket. We don't really need a start date here, but we do want to make sure that this gets done within the next week. So I can set the due date to be a week from today. This time, instead of using content and data from the previous steps, we can go to expression to see what functions we can use. If we scroll down, you can see that there's a date and time section where I can get the current time as well as a function to add days to a specific time. Since we want to add 7 days to today, we'll use the add days function, which takes in a date, which we'll select as UTC now. Oops. And then the next argument that we take is how many days are we adding to this date, which is 7. Once I hit OK, we've set that. And I want to assign this to Vicky on my team because she's the one who is in charge of analyzing the data and insights from our posts. I can save this, and we can go test out our flow right away. I can complete the task. And the task will show up in the follow-ups bucket. There it is. So now Vicky knows that she has to look at the insights for this social media post about Contoso Transit Morale Share, and it's due a week from today. With both of those demos, you can see how you can create quick and easy automations with Planner and Power Automate so you can spend time taking care of what's most important. Combining Power Automate and Planner with the rest of Microsoft 365, or even on its own, creates intelligent task management automation for all. To wrap up this session, here's a list of resources to learn more and stay connected to the Planner team. Check us out online and get involved in our Planner community. You'll most likely find me responding to any questions and comments you have. If you'd like to learn more about Microsoft Planner, what's coming next, and the rest of the Microsoft 365 task ecosystem, I encourage you to check out these other sessions presented by my colleagues. Thank you so much for watching this session. I can't wait to hear about all of the things you do with Power Automate and Planner together.